Science is a serendipitous endeavor. We're exploring nature and trying our best to get at the truth. And every now and then, we're surprised.
When I first heard it, I thought it was too good to be true because, you know, there have been many iterations through my career as a geneticist where people said, oh, we have this method that allows you to change DNA anywhere you want. I thought, well, you know, I've heard that before.
In the simplest terms, CRISPR is a bacteria's version of your immune system.
In the laboratory, we've adapted that bacterial system in a way that we can use it to reprogram genes within our own cells.
I like to use the analogy that CRISPR-Cas9 is like a word processor for our genome. So it's almost like a cursor where you can move it from letter to letter in your DNA.
Until very recently, it's been very difficult to do operations like cut, copy, and paste.
The promise of CRISPR is that you can change DNA in any way you want.
We can literally ask, how do all genes in the genome, all 20,000 genes, how do they influence this one interesting disease or this one interesting facet of biology?
By using CRISPR, we can develop products and novel crops that won't have been possible otherwise.
Discovering drugs, detection, or therapeutics.
The ability to change one base pair at a targeted site in a living cell is something that I think even 5 years ago would have sounded more like science fiction to me.
It's hard to imagine all of the ways that it will be used going forward.
In my 20-year career as a scientist, this is the first time something so transformative has happened.
CRISPR is insanely cool. Very, very big breakthrough.